Hello, with Annette here. In this video I will be talking about the origins of New Year celebrations. The New Year celebrations for many begin on the last day of the Gregorian calendar, which is December 31st, which leads into the early hours of the New Year, January 1st. Where most people attend parties to have drinks, eat food, watch fireworks and make New Year resolutions for them to break. The New Year has not always been celebrated to what many of us know today. 4,000 years ago, the Babylonians celebrated the New Year on the new moon following the vernal equinox. When the light and darkness are equal during a full day, at the end of March. The Babylonians marked this event with a festival known as Akaichu. The name Akaichu derived from Sumerian word meaning barley, due to barley being harvested towards end of March. This festival lasted for 11 days, and on each of those days a different ritual commenced. Marduk, the Babylonian sky god, often became celebrated over this period too, for Marduk's victory over the evil sea goddess Tiamat. This event also brought political purpose to the Babylonians as the king's mandate was renewed, or a new king was crowned. The early Roman calendar had 304 days, which equalized to 10 months. The calendar was created by the founder of Rome, Romulus, in the 8th century BC. Which, like with the Babylonians, the new year was in line with the vernal equinox. King Numa Pompilius later added the months Januarius and Februarius into the calendar, which fell out of sync with the sun over many centuries. Julius Caesar reordered the Roman calendar with the sun, by adding an extra 90 days to the year in 46 BC. After consulting with astronomers and mathematicians, this calendar became known as the Julian calendar. It is this calendar that closely resembles the Gregorian calendar we know today. Julius Caesar used the date January 1st as the first day of the new year to honor Janus. Janus was a two-faced Roman god of beginnings, with one of his faces looking towards the future and the other facing the past. During this period, Romans used to decorate their homes with laurel branches. They also exchanged gifts and held lavish parties. The Egyptians started the new year with the rising of the star called Sirius. The river Nile also flooded when Sirius rose, which is September 11th. Depending on the cycle of the sun, Egyptian years can have 13 months. Some historians believe the first calendars were made during the Bronze Age, but many believe Egyptians made the first calendars known to mankind. Some also believe the Sumerian calendar was the first to be made, followed by the Assyrian and Elamite calendars. This next story may get a little confusing for some listeners. The Chinese celebrated their New Year after the winter solstice, which is marked by the second new moon. Although, it was not always like this. During Western Zhou from 1041 BC to 771 BC, an anonymous farmer wrote a poem called The Classic of Poetry, which describes people celebrating the 10th month of the solar calendar. This poem also describes guest toast with Mijiu. People clean millet stack sites and kill and cook the meat of lambs. In this poem it is also said that people visit their master's home and toast the master with the prospect of living long time together. This celebration is thought to be the prototype for the Chinese New Year. In the records of the Warring States period, which lasted between 475 BC to 221 AD, there is evidence of the Chinese New Year being celebrated. An exorcism took place to expel illness called Big Nuo, in Lushi Chengchiyu, Qin State. This ritual spread after the Qin Dynasty was founded, with the Qin State unifying China. In this period, people thoroughly cleaned their homes in days of celebrating the New Year. During the Han Dynasty, which lasted between 202 BC to 220 AD, Quixi, an Eastern Han agronomist, wrote a book titled Simin Yuling. In this book it describes Zhengrui, which is a celebration on the first day of the month. This celebration is to commemorate ancestors and their fathers with their wife and children. Also mentioned is serving pepper wine to all generations of the family, from children to great-grandchildren. A toast is also made to wish good health upon their parents. Chinese citizens still worship their ancestors in New Year celebrations today. During the Jin Dynasty, which lasted from between 266 AD to 420 AD, a New Year's Eve tradition started called Shuzui, which lasted all night as people stayed awake until sunrise. In an article called Feng Tuji, written by Jin's general Zhu Chu, described Shuzui. Also in the article it describes Kuisui is where people give each other gifts and wish them the best at the end of the year. Bisui is where people invite others for food and drink, and Chuzi was to indicate New Year's Eve. Chuzi is still used by the Chinese people today. Jingchu Suishiji is a book from the North and Southern Dynasties, which describes an ancient Chinese tradition of burning bamboo on New Year's Day. The noise of the crackling bamboo as it was being burned was thought to keep away evil spirits. Bainian Taiwan New Year greeting cards. This tradition became established during the Tang Dynasty. The Emperor Taizong of Tang is said to have started the tradition. The Emperor also wrote whole nation stay together on gold leaves and sent them to his ministers. The custom spread, instead of keeping to the tradition, people would write on xuan paper instead of gold leaves. Some people also believe Bainian Tai is derived from the Han Dynasty. Under the Tang Dynasty, imperial examinations became essential. After pupils received good examination marks, they visited their teacher's home with Menzhuang. Over time, Menzhuang became a symbol of good luck. People started to send these greeting cards to their friends on New Year's Day, calling them Bainian Tai. An emperor of the later Shu, Meng Cheng, who reigned from 935 to 965 AD, wrote Chunlian. During the Five Dynasties and Ten Kingdoms, enjoying the past legacies in the new year, the holiday foreseeing the last longing spring was written, which is described in the book Shu Dao Wu Volume 2, written by Zhang Tangying, who was a Song Dynasty official. The scholar Xin Yingsun was ordered by the emperor on New Year's Day to write couplets on peach wood and hang them above the emperor's door. Placing the couplets above the door within days of the new year is believed the tradition became widespread during the Song Dynasty. Wang Ashni, who was a famous northern Song literator, philosopher, poet and politician, wrote about the custom in his poem New Year's Day. In another poem called Yuanri, includes the words Bao Jiu, which is thought to be referred to firecrackers instead of burning bamboo, which Chinese people still say Bao Jiu to refer to them both. During the Tang Dynasty, gunpowder was invented, which was also largely used during the Song Dynasty, when people placed gunpowder in bamboo shoots, which made a louder explosion to ward off evil spirits. Later during the Song Dynasty, people stopped using bamboo shoots. Instead they used paper cylinders and filled them with gunpowder. They also started to create the gunpowder whip, which is known in Chinese as Bian Pao. These are created by hemp rope being attached to the firecrackers. Both of these are still used in present day by the Chinese people to celebrate the New Year and other festivities. People started to give children money to celebrate the New Year during the Song Dynasty. The money was called Suanian Qian, meaning the money based on age. Vilin Shi is a book, in its final chapter Ending of a Year. The writer referred to this act by recording the emperor preparing coins to give to the princes and princesses and wishing them long lives. Under the Yuan Dynasty, people started to hand out year cakes, known as Nian Gao, to their relatives. Jizo, which means eating Chinese dumplings, was established under the Ming Dynasty. The book Yajongzhai, which translates to people up at 5 in the morning of New Year's Day, burn incense and light firecrackers, throw door latch or wooden bars in the air 3 times, drink pepper and thuja wine, eat dumplings, describes eating dumplings. People would also place two silver coins inside the dumplings. Whoever found the coins would attain wealth for a year. In modern China, people put things like dates into their dumplings, which according to prophecy, this act will bring a flourish new year. If people place candy into their dumplings, it predicts sweet days. It is recorded in the book Qing Liuju, elders give children coins that are threaded together by red thread. This can be dated back to the Qing dynasty. This is still a tradition kept by Chinese people. They either keep it to the old tradition of threading the coins together, or the coins are placed into a colorful purse. When the Kuomintang party ruled China in 1928, it was decreed that New Year's Day would fall on January 1st in line with the Gregorian calendar. This became abandoned due to the overwhelming opposition. During the Cultural Revolution in 1967, New Year celebrations were banned in China. The People's Republic of China's State Council announced the people of China should change their customs and have a revolutionized Fighting Spring Festival. In 1980, the old New Year celebrations were reinstated. Little history about the Gregorian calendar. The Christians in the medieval period temporarily stopped New Year celebrations on January 1st. Anglo-Saxons held their New Year on December 25th and the medieval Christians held their New Year's Day on Feast of Annunciation, which was held on March 25th. Which in Christian belief, this is the day Angel Gabriel visited Mary to give her the news that she would be impregnated with God's child. Pope Gregory XIII restabilized New Year's Day as being January 1st in 1582. The Gregorian calendar back then seems messed up to how we know it today. Aloysius Lilius, who was an astronomer and a doctor, alongside Christopher Clavius, an astronomer and a Jesuit priest, made the final modifications to the Gregorian calendar. This calendar became more accurate than the one created by Julius Caesar. This new calendar treats each year as having 365 days, 5 hours and 49 minutes. During the 13 centuries, the vernal equinox slipped to March 10th. Christopher Calavius verified Easter would still keep to the traditional date of March 21st. The papal bull Inter Gravissimas of February 24, 1582, caused Gregory to subsequently decree the Thursday, October 4, 1582 would not be followed by the 5th, but October the 15th would follow the day after. The Gregorian calendar became known as so, due to Gregory's involvement. This new calendar was very much disliked at first, as many thought it was one way of landlords being able to force another week and half rent from the tenants. Christian countries like Italy, Poland, Portugal and Spain were quickly to accept the new calendar. However, Germany and Switzerland were religiously split, did not accept the new calendar until a year or so later, alongside some states of the Dutch Republic and France. Protestant Europe did not accept this new calendar until a century had passed. Between 1700 and 1701, Denmark and the Holy Roman Empire accepted this calendar alongside the Protestant states of the Dutch Republic and Switzerland. America and Great Britain accepted the Gregorian calendar in 1752. In September of that year, the 2nd was immediately followed by the 14th. In 1753, the new calendar was accepted by the country of Sweden. This calendar was not accepted in Eastern Christendom until about 700 years later, where the calendar is known as the civil calendar instead of the Gregorian calendar. Thank you for listening. Please like and subscribe if you like my content. To keep up to date with my future videos, follow me on Twitter @withanet1.